test for convergent. Sigma un is equal to 2n minus 1 whole by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2. Sigma un is equal to 2n minus 1 whole by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2. Let un is equal to 2n minus 1 by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2. We want to do this problem by limit comparison test. What is limit comparison test? If sigma un and sigma vn are two series of positive terms such that limit un by vn is equal to L not equal to 0, then sigma un and sigma vn converge or diverge together. The un and unknown series are convergent or divergent according. We have to consider a sequence Vn, a series Vn, and we have to perform the point Un by Vn. If limit Un by Vn is equal to L not equal to 0, then Un and Vn converge or diverge together. We choose Vn equal to 1 by n square. So just we have to write the highest power of n in the numerator, that is n, by highest power of the n, highest nth power in denominator. In this, the denominator has n cube, which is n into n. So denominator has the highest power n, n cube. Numerator highest power n is n, so n by n cube. We take 1 by n square. So vn is equal to 1 by n square. So let sigma vn. Sigma 1 by n square. This is a convergent series. So 1 by n for p, for p greater than 1, it is convergent. There is a test called auxiliary series test. Sigma 1 by n for p converges for p greater than 1, diverges for p less than or equal to 1. We consider un by vn. Here un is 2n minus 1 by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2, and we considered vn as 1 by n square. Now un by vn is equal to 2n minus 1 by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 by 1 by n square. We know that a by b by c by d gives a by b into d by c. The denominator take reverse position. So 2n minus 1 by n into n plus 1 into n plus 2, this is the numerator, into, we can take the reciprocal of the denominator as n square by 1. So it is 2n minus 1 into n square in the numerator, and n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 is in the denominator. Take n common in the numerator, then we get n into 2 minus 1 by n into n square by n into, if we take n common in the denominator, in this term we get n into 1 plus 1 by n. And here also we want to take n outside, so n into 1 plus 2 by n. So in the numerator n into n square n cube is there. In the denominator is also n into n, n cube is there. So by cancelling both, so n, n square, n cube, and denominator n into n cube, they will get cancelled. The remaining terms are 2 minus 1 by n by 1 plus 1 by n into 1 plus 2 by n by cancelling the n powers. Now, if we take limit n tends to infinity un by vn, we take as limit n tends to infinity 2 minus 1 by n by 1 plus 1 by n into 1 plus 2 by n. So, as n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0, therefore 2 minus 0 by 1 plus 0 into 1 into 1 plus 0 by 1. Therefore, 2 minus 0 by 1 into 1, this is equal to 2, not equal to 0. Since limit n tends to infinity un by vn is not equal to 0, vn and un converge or diverge together. By limit comparison test, un and vn are converged or diverged together. We know that here vn is a convergent series, therefore un is also a convergent series. So, in the given problem, we take the highest powers of n in the numerator by highest powers of n in the denominator, and we choose Vn like this. This is the shortcut way to choose Vn. So after getting Vn, by the Arzachs disease test or power test, we can assess the nature of this VN. VN is convergent or divergent. Now we have to perform limit n tends to infinity UN by VN. If it is finite value, then UN and VN are converged or diverged together. With this principle, we find the nature of the given problem.